That's what I'm talking about, bro. These One Piece fans, bro. I'm sick and tired of y'all. Y'all got cock on the mind 24/7.
Salutations, brethren. Welcome to another weekly emotional discourse. We're back with One Piece chapter 1057. I'm here with Zero.
You already know it's your boy Zero to the motherfucking D Brando.
Yeah. I'm here with Afro.
What's good, guys?
And I'm here with No Show Momo.
It's me.
No Kyle. Damn. I don't know if you guys remember what happened in the last chapter, but actually, I don't know. I don't remember what happened in the last
chapter. What happened last chapter is that Kid, Luffy, and Law are battling. The low key beefing.
Yeah, that's true.
Buggy and Crocodile are under.
Working
together.
Crocodile and Mihawk are under Buggy right now. Quote unquote under, but like because you know Buggy's the Yonko, but Kid, Law, and Luffy were like these niggas tripping. You know what I'm saying? Like And then so Luffy left early to go to the sale. And Momosuke and Kinemon are very mad about that. And Yamato is just like, this is when I start my journey as Odin.
Yamato may join the crew.
Perfect recap. All right.
Any predictions? I have none. I don't know what the fuck's going on.
Okay, I have a prediction. Give me a second.
For my predictions, I'm assuming like we're gonna see them finally depart. I'm assuming that like they'll see Momonosuke off at the shore and be like, "Yo, bro."
Sorry. I got cut off midway, bro. But
you good?
My prediction is that I'm gonna say my prediction I had before I read spoilers. Right?
Oh my goodness.
This has been my prediction. Fuck Yamato. Yamato's not joined. Piece of shit, motherfucker. Fuck that shit.
Why? You know what the?
Listen, I love Yamato. He's a great character, but that nigga has not brought anything to the crew yet. We cannot add Yamato. Like, the only way I can see does Yamato even read a text?
When has that ever mattered?
No, I'm saying Yamato brings nothing to the crew. Everybody brought something to the crew,
but
Yamato.
Luffy doesn't care about that.
I know, but still, it's Oda always does this. If you're a part of the crew, you have something you have to bring to the table. Okay,
what if Yamato has a talent that the crew can use? You don't know that.
Okay, what talent?
I don't know. What does the crew need?
Well, okay. So my prediction is Yamato. Listen, I think Yamato should stay back because if they're not staying back, I'm being honest. Green Bull just gonna return and fuck them niggas up, bro.
No, he's not. Freaking Momonosuke handled him. Yamato wasn't even there.
Momonosuke did not handle him. Shanks did, bro.
No. Even if Shanks wasn't there. Momonosuke
was getting hands.
Exactly. Momonosuke had the B money.
I generally think Wano, like, so don't even know, everybody's strong as fuck on Wano, like, if we're thinking about it. Because, like, everybody in Wano could have probably washed pre-time skip Luffy. You know what I'm saying? Like, almost everybody. It's like I feel like that's like an agreement, right? Like that's no doubt about it because they all know hockey and everything and advanced hockey shit like that, right? But in my opinion, I don't think Wano is taking on the Marines if they come through without Yamato.
They've already beat the Marines, bro.
Did not beat the Marines.
Green Bull got whooped. I don't care.
Shanks was there to stop him, bro.
Even if he wasn't, Green Bull was getting mixed regardless.
Listen, you don't want to mess with Shanks because he's gonna hit you with the bang.
That's all right?
All right. So that's all I'm saying. Number one, number two, Yamato brings nothing to the crew. Number three, it would make Jinbei joining the crew so anticlimactic because Jinbei literally has no screen time being part of the crew. He just comes. They didn't even drink the whole sake. It was like mid war. It's like let's welcome Jinbei to the crew. They got the alcohol. They're like, wait, we gotta start fighting. And it feels like fuck. Jinbei, don't get me wrong, he's that nigga, but he needs his time with the crew before somebody else joins.
He's been with them since Fishman Island. It's okay.
He's been with them since Fishman Island?
Yeah.
What?
Remember, he was there at Fishman Island, remember?
Okay, but he wasn't there until fucking Whole Cake. And even then, at fucking Wano, everybody was split up for damn near the whole arc until the very end.
It's okay. I think Yamato joining the crew is fine.
Honestly, I just hope this act ends and we can move on to a different island. All right. Well, we gotta
see what happens.
All right. I don't care about Uta. Film Red reaction coming soon. As always, Robin Pete, what's up? Very nice, very cool. Cover story, chapter 1057, the final cray. Yo!
It's Whoa! Caesar's there?
Who's he blowing? Yeah,
they got Caesar on the crew, bro, on the team.
Category is pulling him weight.
Where's Category?
He's long in the back, right there. Right
my
on
question
him.
Is, does he just jump all of them at the same time?
I'm guessing.
He just killed all of them. That'd be crazy.
Caesar's so poison crazy. Gas attack. That's crazy.
Caesar's gonna get his ass flipped though next chapter. Like,
he
no
definitely
way.
Is. Why does he keep doing this? He should have just snuck out. He should have just flown away.
We doing too much, bro.
His guys aren't anymore.
We doing too
right?
much.
He's no back thing. To his OG form. He has such a clean design though.
I hate his face, but like in a good way. But still, like I feel like he'd be so cool if he didn't have such a goofy face.
Yeah,
but that's the appeal.
Ugly ass.
All right.
Let's go.
Bing, bing, bing. Dark clouds gather. A tale is being told in the capital. A storm echoes through the sky, consuming Onigashima. Bing, bing, bing. The roar of the Azure Dragon and the howls of a countless other beast join the cacophony. At Habu Port, the scattered leaves of fall are bleached, auburn in the pattering rain. The stage is set for a tale of duty and honor. This is the story of the royal retainers and their quest to let Kozuki Oda's name shine once more.
Yo!
Many a hardship lie in wait, but they stay resolute to meet their fate. The Red Scabbards. The evening of the Fire Festival starts to unfold.
Of course, near Tokyo Court Town.
What? You're not hanging out to see?
No!
Yes, sir!
Yamato? No, yes, I'm staying. Oh. I've already spoken to Luffy.
Roger's base channel is gone. Roger's base channel is gone.
Trash. Yes.
We got debated. We got debated.
Yes, why? I wanted them to join.
I told y'all he was not joining. Bro.
You read spoilers.
No. Okay, I want to say this, though. I've been saying this shit for months. You can't say I haven't.
They can be like the ship painter, bro. That's cool. That's
fun. Painter? Wait, do they paint?
I don't think so, but they can learn.
Okay. You see, maybe this is what this time skip is for. After the time skip, he's gonna be like the fucking painter, bro. Like
so whack, bro.
Roger's base. I feel bad.
No show in shambles right now.
Literally.
I'm letting you know, man. This is our funeral for you. I'm going to be clapping at it. Everyone's going to be wanting. I know.
Did Yamato at least say, like, I knew Ace and, like, explain all that?
Hold on. Are you really content with this, Yamato?
Aren't I welcome here?
You are. You're just confused. A moment ago, you said you made up your mind.
Oh, that? Well, Oda started his journey with the Tour of Wano, right? I realize there's so much out there that I don't understand, but I'm sure I'll find my way if I follow in his footsteps. And I'm bound to make it out to sea sooner or later.
Unbelievable. You were able to tell them all about this.
This guy wants to take a tour of your own city? You're wag!
What if Yamato takes down the borders by accident?
That doesn't... They must have intentionally snubbed me. Why bid farewell to everyone but us?
Your name? Your father was a fool of a lord. Identify yourself. I'm Luffy.
So what if you're a warrior? I'm going to be king of the pirates one day. So there.
Well, one day I'm going to be anointed Shogun of Wano. So take that, you halfwit.
Big talk for an eel.
You're nothing but an ignorant ape.
Whoa.
What are you, Momo? Just some figurehead? Are you just going to stand there and cry?
Be Kaido.
All right, then let's team up. It's an alliance. Luffy.
Spirit, Momo. Maybe be thoroughly jumped up.
Top-notted brat, but you're right. Find a way to survive. We'll have your back. Don't forget, we're pals.
What is your name?
The man who will be Shogun of Wano.
Bro, they were really kicking this little kid's ass, bro.
You know he definitely said, "Shogun of Wano."
Literally, bro. Fat ass lips, solid ass face.
Gonna
Go. Am I getting recapped right now?
Yeah, we're literally.
I'll tell you. It's just Momo's mad pissed that Luffy not saying bye, right? So he's remembering all the times with them.
I don't give a fuck. Remember. Why are we getting a recap in manga, bro?
You like that, bro?
In his feels right now, bro.
What's going on?
Momo's in this field, but he's really like, Luffy really dipped and didn't say bye to me, you little bitch, nigga. Like, that's what he feels right now.
No, I mean, I get it. I'd be sad too. But
remember also, Momo, if this is the last chapter of Wano, Momonosuke is the main character of Wano.
True.
Word. So this is Momonosuke's farewell. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's the oldest way of saying, yo, like, it shows Oda, like, loves his side characters, right? He always tried to do them right. It's just Momo's like, you could tell he didn't really like Big Mom like that, but he fucked with Kaido a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Like, but like, you know what I'm saying? So like, he said, this is basically the farewell to like him being part of the main cast.
And we never see him ever again.
No, Momo's case, he's literally Vivi. He's just a new age Vivi.
You're not wrong, basically. Go, you can fly.
Right.
Stop Onigashima in his tracks. I will definitely beat Kaido.
You might not have all.
you gotta go.
He said, "Huff huff."
We might not have always gone along. We still came a long way together. Is he really that heartless? I was wrong about you, Luffy. You fiend. He's mistaken being free for being rude. Am I in the rock anymore?
Not at all. By the way, Momonosuke-sama, is there a reason we aren't flying? What the hell?
He just been levitating? This man different.
Yeah, he's running, bro. That's his feet touching the ground. Bro? He's running.
Bro, Gear 5 still has effect on Momonosuke, bro, with the fucking feet, bro. Momonosuke-sama, you are undisputed shogun of Wano now. Depending on Luffy Dono's words, I may have no choice but to cleave him from... Jesus Christ,
Kinemon,
yo.
Shut up, bro. Who you slicing, bro?
Bro, Kinemon is the nigga that... Bro, Kinemon actually is the most lucky. He should be dead right now, bro. Why are you...
I thought you ain't put your hand on Luffy's back like, please, Kenny Wano, on your shoulders.
Nigga, bro, was crying like a bitch to Luffy. Put his hand on his heart like, like, shut up.
Like, tough talk, talking from the guy who was introduced without a torso. You were a head on top of some legs, okay. My dude. Exactly. That is the way of the samurai. I thought we were pals, Luffy.
I think you're blowing this out of proportion.
Overlooking us without giving us a few blows and bites of out of our question.
No blows, no bites. Just like
wait, time out. Hey, yo. Bro, want a blow?
Bites. He just showed it a while now. I guess he can do it for you.
Bro, looking at the One Piece memes too much.
Tokagi
All right,
Udon.
The next time we meet, it'll be as enemy. Don't whine to me if we are shooting to kill.
Gotcha.
See you around, Traff. Buzzer off.
Set sail.
Okay, no matter what, I love the dynamic because they're literally, I think people forgot, all these niggas are enemies.
Right?
In the grand scheme of things, like, I've been saying Law and Luffy are probably going to, like, have, like, a little scuffle, right? In the near future, right? I think, like, in 100 or 200 chapters, right? Because they're literally... They're pirates. They're not. It's not no Whitebeard alliance. Happen to be there just to happen to be there, bro. That's literally it.
Yo, I never peeped that kid's ship has a whole dead fish on it.
Yeah, I haven't seen his ship in a long time.
Okay, I want to say one thing. I want to see Law smile again. Like, you remember Law pre-time skip? That nigga was a mischief ass nigga.
Last time he smiled was probably during the alliance. So he was like, "Yeah, we're gonna fuck up Don Flamingo," and then Then he had Chopper writing his son. He was like, "I missed a mistake."
No, actually, I think the last time he smiled was I think he's when they first met him at Punk Hazard, and the nigga was just switching everybody's bodies for no fucking reason, bro.
Oh, I thought you were about to see the dick picture before the time skip.
If you know, if you know, you know. If you know, you know.
Where? What do you mean? Put the picture up? You want to get demonetized? You want to get banned?
If you know, you know. Normal picture. All you guys.
Okay, just put the black bars on it. Put the black bars.
No, just put the normal picture. Just like literally, the normal picture is good enough, bro.
That's what I'm talking about, bro. These One Piece fans, bro. I'm sick and tired of y'all. Y'all got cock on the mind 24/7. Hey!
Oh!
You monster!
Hey, we've come to see you off.
Yo,
Yamato-chan.
Yo, Momosuke is like... Yo, bro,
what big ass dragon though?
Yeah, bro.
This nigga, an asshole, bro. Look at this nigga. He, like, he's spazzing out, bro.
Hold
Luffy. What?
Got you, Luffy. Luffy, you dastardous! What is the meaning of this outrage? How can you abandon the two comrades you have known the longest without a word? Have you angered the Shogun? What do you have to say for yourself?
What's the big deal? We're meeting now, aren't we?
Right, Sanji and Zoro just let this happen?
Yeah.
They're letting the... Bro, look at Yamato. Yeah. Just holding on him, but like...
Happily.
Yeah, like, Yamato's happy, Kirimon, and Momosuke, like, you fucking bitch.
Mm-hmm. Luffy, this is an edict from the Shogun. Please don't leave. I'll be so lonely. I want to be with you forever.
We got to leave your friend's house, man. Like, we gotta
If my man said, yo, get out. The summer party's done, bro.
Yo, when the barbecue is over, bro.
This man, Momonosuke is such
when you got to leave your cousin's house, bro.
Loser, bro.
And it's the cousin with the AC? Damn.
When you leave the nigga where you got all the video games, right? You got all the Nintendo Xbox, bro. Oh, no!
This is probably why Luffy left without saying anything, because he knew he was going to cry like a freaking baby. My god, bro. This is so embarrassing, bro. You're the Shogun of Wano, bro. Get your shit together.
I mean, to be fair, he is technically
8. Man, I don't care, bro. He's a Shogun, bro. He needs to.
He can't be like this.
If he was sad, it'd be one thing. But look at the way he's crying, man.
Literally.
My man is fucking going through it.
Please, no, please. That type shit, bro.
I've only managed to survive because you were there. You're the reason I can laugh again. Thank you so much for avenging my father.
Everyone's smiling,
and
bro.
My mother.
Look at Frankie and Chopper, bro.
Yeah. And
he's so bad as well.
Robin, beautiful as usual. You already know.
I can't even express myself properly now. I'm scared of what happens next. Please don't go.
Quite pitiful sight. That's a little kid on the inside.
That's Zoro and Jinbei.
What's up?
Hey, that Jinbei over there? No, they did my boy so dirty.
Jinbei looking like a 100-100 background.
Jinbei really get turned into a side character, bro. How you doing, hey,
bro? It's okay.
Yo, is that supposed to be chest hair? What is that?
I don't know. I think that's his chin. I don't know.
No, bro. His chest hair is literally just like a fucking autograph, bro. Like, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That's what crazy. Even Usa, what the fuck is going on, bro? Usopp, yeah, it's ready.
Is that Momo?
Yeah, it's Momonosuke.
Did it give him a flag? We've been waiting here all this time because I wanted to give you this. Even if you're a bit bigger now, I know what you like on the inside. You are a small, weak dummy. But
you just skipped this whole part. You can't play the tough shogun with me,
Momo. You are a small, weak dummy.
He was but dumb as hell.
I think it'd be like a little brother.
Let's go.
It's a flag. When times are tough, look at it and remember your seafaring adventures. Hang it up somewhere in Wano.
That's
when
a
major bad news comes knocking, just point him to it. Ooh, Yo, Luffy mocked his territory. That's crazy.
I was about to say
the same way Whitebeard was like, yeah, I'll hold down Fishman Island. Luffy just said, I got Wano on my back. Fuck out of here.
So Luffy got Wano. Let's be honest. He got Alabasta.
He has Fishman Island, too.
He has Fishman Island.
Oh, yeah. He officially has Fishman Island. He has
his whole fleet from Dressrosa. That's right.
Bro, Law and Kid gotta be pissed. Yo, Law's gotta be, let's be honest, Law's definitely angrier than Kid. No, he's just depressed now. He's like, damn. what land do I have? Yo,
right.
Yo, what land do I have? But yeah, let's go. And we'll let them know that you're screwing with our friends. It's the same as screwing with us.
Does that mean I'm one of you?
No.
Kinemo, Yamato, Momo, if any of you ever want to be pirates, I'll come for you right away.
Yeah.
All
right.
Just remember, I won't have any weaklings on board.
Let's go. So it's just like Vivi. They're honorary members that just aren't like on the ship.
Yeah. Take care of him, Yamato.
Yeah.
Yeah, you already know. She got the strength.
Keep it together, Shogun. Good luck, Momonosuke.
Fuck Momonosuke, bro.
Yeah,
he, really, he got a whole Odin blade, and he's over here. Yay!
Bro was like, yo, Zoro, can you teach me something?
Can you get your goofy ass? Oh, no one else is bowing except for him. Kinemon. Yes. Mark my words. Someday, I will surpass Kozuki Odin.
I will be by your side when you do.
You're talking about me? Shut the heck up, y'all. No! Alrighty, let's set course for Hakumai. The main port is there. I was told there's a lift that can lower ships down.
I thought since we scaled a waterfall to get here, we have to fall down it to leave.
Me too, thank goodness.
Man, why is he so close? Wait, he hit that shit like the Street Fighter Third Strike announcer. Yeah, that makes sense.
that makes sense. You guys will use the main port. It's a safe and sound way after all.
He's such a loser.
Perfect for you, wusses.
Bro, you're not a Yonko. Don't talk to him. You're on a lower level.
Yeah, I know. Kenny's just being bad jealous, bro.
His ship's going to break.
I hope it does, bro.
Nah, look, peep. Keep it going. Here it is.
Safe and sound. How did Law get freaking... Why he wasn't even talking to you?
Nah, he heard that shit, bro. He okay, loud as hell.
No, he's safe and sound is good. Don't let him get to you.
Hang on, Captain. What's with that face? We all think that main port is better. Jinbei, give me the help.
Damn.
Stop it. Take this. No, we're all gonna die.
Imagine they die here.
The might of the outlaws recruited by Lord Momonosuke and Kinemon made them all akin to real-life wisdom kings. Their power descended like a wrathful tsunami, obliterating all in its path.
So funny. I'm not gonna lie. I like how they're leaving Wano, bro. This is how you leave a country, bro.
This is so stupid.
This is how you leave a country. This is how you leave a... You know what? Kid is really instigated just to be on the left and not in the middle. That's crazy.
Right?
Yeah.
And look, okay. look how there's more distance between Kid and Luffy than there is between Law and Kid.
Yeah.
I mean, Law and Luffy.
That's kind of funny. Yo, Law got that. Oh, yeah, Law got a submarine. I remember, bro.
Is it made out of metal? If so, he's probably fine. Like, it'll still be fucked, but...
No, I mean, he'll be far better than the Sun. Oh, no, Sunny's like... Oh, I don't know about Kid, though. Like,
this shit made out of bones, bro.
Yeah, I don't know about Kid.
And obliterating on impact. Anyways. Even Kaido, the Dragon King, and the yokai-possessed giant Ouran failed to withstand their assault. The heavens themselves were torn as painful shrieks reverberated through the air. During that chaos, Princess Yori was accused by Orochi, the snake that seemingly perished in the flames, in a desperate last-ditch attempt for his spiteful vengeance. His gambit was thwarted by a single slash. And who owns that blade that separated Orochi from his final curse head? Why, none other than Kozuki Oden's second disciple, Denjiro. With his last one detached and burning, the twisted Korozumi was at long last brought to his knees. Ba-ben. And then a flash of lightning marked the fall of Onigashima, and with it, the fall of the Dragon King, Kaido. The sun had finally pierced the dark clouds that were suffocating Wano for 20 long years.
The dawn. Let's go.
The skies were clear. Okay. Sounds from the ignorant masses celebrating the fire festival in the capital crept into their ears. Patom. Then suddenly, defying all reason, the burning remains of Orochi spoke. The Korozumi family's grudge shall continue to curse this Ryan land, generation after generation, for all eternity. But Princess Yuri refused to flinch or shudder. She held her gaze. The country's 20 years worth of torturous memories fueled her heart. Oh, shit, hold on.
I don't know what I'm looking at.
Stand back. It's too dangerous, Yuri-sama, cried the samurai Denjiro, but she took off her head. Our beloved Princess Yuri did not yield even one step. Staring into Orochi's devilish face, she delivered a damning epitaph. Her fan and held aloft the Kozuki crest proudly dancing on its edge. No longer having to bite her tongue like she did for the last 20 years, she cried out, Father, mother, brother, and our homeland, hear this. Korozumi means charcoal. They were born to burn.
I never looked this up this entire time.
She got bar.
She got bar. Yeah, Jay-Z writing this down right now, bro. This panel,
wild.
Why Orochi got blasted like DBZ in the top left, though?
Right?
Yo, all I'm saying, give it 3 months to talk here. Peso references. You know what I'm saying?
Right. That's a fact.
This is clean, though. I was wondering what happened. With this part, I'm glad like he told us what happened.
That's nerd court niggas, write this down.
Yeah, write this down. This is it, bro. This is a bar.
Yeah, if I see any new One Piece raps saying this shit.
Woo! This is double battle with you. Oh damn, I suck at reading these panels, bro.
I saw you skipped it, but then I was like,
hey, bro, you should have just said, woo, this is the boy I'm waiting for, and everyone all together.
This is what I've been waiting for. This is what I'm talking about.
Damn. That's crazy.
Beben.
Feedback. Wait, they have TV in One Piece. Never mind, but not Wano.
Man, what?
They have TV in One Piece, but not. I was saying this is their TV, but then I realized they had TV in One Piece.
Yeah, they definitely do. And now the time slides ahead to the day after the festival, where feuds and weapons get finally rest. A shocking truth is revealed at the port where the reversed crescent moons meet. The denouement? The denouement of this violent saga is a joyous reunion. The blood spilt in order to revive this clan will never be forgotten. A record of their sacrifices will always be carried by the wind. Woo!
Bars.
Okay, I want to say Wano is a saga, anyways.
Absolutely.
Part of the record is referenced on novel, Shinsuke Bibo Wind Record. True. That concludes today's tale and on our nation's renowned samurai. Bro, why does Raizo look the same, bro?
Damn.
What the fuck?
He just got his nutrients sucked out like two minutes ago.
Right? Look at Shinobu, bro. Bad as hell.
Bad as fuck, bro.
And meanwhile, Raizo, right, same China ass head with the spider legs on
his. He got his whole dome sucked off like not long ago. Leave him alone.
Nah, bro.
Wasn't Raizo bullied for being ugly as a kid? Yeah,
definitely.
Shinobu, I bet Shinobu didn't have to deal with that. Shinobu just like,
hell no. Shinobu said, listen, y'all think I'm a little small, a little chub, not right now, but watch later.
I'm not just like, people hate on, listen, I think the problem when people rate Wano, they don't see it as a saga. You know what I'm saying? They see it as one arc. And because they don't see it as a saga, it ruins the experience for them. So it gives them the Alabasta experience, because Alabasta is a saga also. You know what I'm saying?
I think
as a saga, this was really good. Like, the best saga ever, though, if we're comparing sagas, is Marineford. I don't think anybody's touching Marineford in sagas. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I think Marineford probably might be the best saga of all shonen manga, in my opinion, because that shit is crazy, bro.
It's a great opinion.
It's a great opinion, ain't it? Like, am I wrong? Like,
you really said, bro. Let's finish this chapter.
It's a great opinion. Let's believe like that, bro. We gotta finish this manga.
And
my bad.
On our nation's
renowned. Return to us.
Yeah. Momonosuke-sama.
With that, I think a well-earned break is in order.
Now, where shall we place this flag?
On the fucking castle, nigga.
Oh, see you again. Farewell.
Let me see.
The curtain's closed.
Final curtain. There you go.
We're out. We're done.
Yo, I'm not gonna lie. Why don't ending like this is like I could die right now and I'll be satisfied with One Piece, bro. You know what I'm saying? No, I'll be satisfied, bro. I do say because it's like, bro, Wano has been like hyped up since Thriller Bark, right? But like, it was definitely like the only disappointing thing about Wano I'd have to say is Zoro not getting that much. Let's be honest, Zoro.
Right. He like, still didn't open his eye.
Yeah, Zoro didn't get that much, but
Luffy, I don't think he will, bro.
Bro, I'm not gonna. It's gonna feel so. It's gonna actually be like this is the. You can take a break from One Piece now, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I think what's gonna happen now is not necessarily a time skip, but more like they're gonna focus on other characters and like other things, especially at the Reverie. Probably like clear up some of the shit of like the final discussions, and I know there's obviously like my expectations of like what to expect later, but I feel like they're gonna focus more on the side characters to then come back to the Straw Hats type shit.
I hope they do that.
I think we have to just officially set the rest of the world up in a certain way where we know it's endgame, but not endgame for the Straw Hats just yet. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like, because they,
they already did that though with the you know Sabo going crazy.
No, but they just showed us a little bit. Like I'm trying to figure out how the fuck did he become Flame Emperor. I'm trying to figure out about the freaking the buggy crew. What happened with Boa Hancock? There's so much stuff I need.
Okay, I'm gonna be honest. Like I don't think One Piece has ever revealed anything like that to ourselves. That's that major. You know what I mean? Like they're always hinted, but the reveal always comes from somebody from the Straw Hats meeting somebody. You know what I mean? Like the true reveal. You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I think? Hard prediction. Blackbeard's going to try to get Doflamingo.
You think Doflamingo would join Blackbeard?
I mean, hey, freedom's freedom.
I think there will be another prison break. That's what I feel.
I think Blackbeard's going to break into Maria to Impel Down twice, bro. kill Magellan this time, bro.
Nah, this time he's thinking Magellan, too. He's like, bro, we already got the other warden, bro. Just join the crew, man.
Yo, that'd actually be... Bro, this gotta be another... Because I feel like Doflamingo's too important just to leave him.
I feel the same, but, like, I don't know why they'd make Blackbeard break him out again, though. I feel like it'd be weird. It'd be, like, redundant for
Blackbeard to go back. Where's Blackbeard going, then?
Wano.
I don't know. That's what Oda needs to tell us, right?
He coming for Pluton real quick.
There's a lot that needs to be done. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what to really say either to like have expectations of exactly what's going to be done. But like, there definitely has to be some focus on the side characters for just a little bit more before it's like back to the Straw Hats. That's my assumption. I could just say fuck you and just go straight.
The only person we don't know anything about right now is Blackbeard, realistically.
Yeah.
Because we got updates on Buggy. We got updates on every Yonko, but Black. No, they're gonna tell us the aftermath. Like we're gonna find out what happened with Ball.
Oh, we're gonna meet
with who?
What is the name? Weevil.
I think the way it's gonna happen is that they're gonna get to wherever location they need to get to, and I think like being who I'm assuming will be Nami, that gets like a newspaper or some shit of like the world events, and like start talking about it, like in a way that they can update the bounties for everybody and like all that shit had they done before. I feel like it's gonna have to be that way. I also feel like Nami's like the only person besides Robin that knows how to read.
That would make sense. I could see them reading a newspaper and they're like, "Oh my god,
this." You know, to read. I don't know about Zoro though.
Zoro?
I don't think it's bro. Zoro can't even fucking see with one eye, bro.
That is true.
I'll say the thing about I think Sanji is just as capable as Nami or Robin. He's just a womanizer.
Yeah, you know.
But we got Jinbei off. Bro, that's why I think Jinbei is the nigga they needed to get serious.
Absolutely. I mean, bro, like from this point on, this is what Oda considered to be the official, like the final ride, and more so like this is now the arc about the One Piece, because apparently everything else from the beginning of the series to now was Luffy getting his crew.
Literally, which is so crazy. Bro really said, yeah, I spent 20 years setting up the story, and now we can start the right with the real story.
This is crazy, bro.
Damn.
Yo, gonna die. I think niggas are gonna finally die. Oh, this Straw Hat crew, bro. Because Everything's set up. Everybody's set up.
Who would die?
If Jinbei died, I'd be so mad.
Nah, they can't kill Jinbei, that's on racism, right? I feel like okay, people we know can't die for sure. Robin can't die for sure. Robin is too important to die. If they kill Robin, it's actually game over.
If Robin dies, I might quit the series.
Robin would definitely be okay. So everybody I think can die right now: Chopper, Robin, Frankie.
Nah, I don't think Frankie either. Frankie is like pretty important. We need Frankie for Vegapunk. They can't kill Mafia.
I know, but the thing is though, Frankie's okay. What? Okay, realistically, why does Frankie want to meet Vegapunk? Did he ever say anything about that?
I don't know.
He's a scientist, bro. Or Frankie's not even a scientist. That nigga's just a he's just an engineer.
Bro, Frankie's the closest connection to Vegapunk we have. Aside from freaking Caesar.
Kuma.
I feel like Frankie will be able to do something for Kuma, so I don't know.
Kuma is just... But that means they would run into the Revolutionary Army, which they're going to. But...
Yeah, I feel like they definitely have to at some point. Especially if they're rolling with Vivi, then...
But what if Sabo tries to recruit Luffy? Like, Luffy, bro, we need your dumbass right now.
For the Revolutionary Army? I don't think Luffy would agree.
No, Sabo would be like, dog, I need you. Luffy would be like, I got you,
nigga. If it's to help, oh yeah, but I don't think he'd like, officially join.
No, he wouldn't officially join, but, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He'd be like, yo, Sabo, make sure to use his flag whenever when you're beefing with somebody, bro.
If that's the case, bro, the Marines are going to have a tough time, bro.
That's a fact, bro.
Marines are already depressed, bro. They got... Yeah, the Marines have no influence again over the world, bro. Yeah.
Which is so funny, because I like how freaking Akainu moved the... Navy headquarters into the new world to be like, yeah, we're showing everybody we're not letting the new world be ruled by Yonkos, just for them to just get freaking constantly bitched and disrespected.
Problem with the Marines is that they don't use the admirals.
I mean, they try. It's just the admirals don't listen to them because they're like, bro, the Marines are fucking up, or the Marines aren't strong enough.
Okay, to be fair, Fujitora was not even at Dressrosa to get Luffy, though. He was just trying to check up on Doflamingo.
Yeah, and then he realized, damn, bro, the Marines are folding, bro. We are my team folded. I can't let them get away with this.
The problem with Akainu is that he just doesn't send Kizaru, bro. Like, if he just used Kizaru more, life would be way better.
But he knows if he sent Kizaru, like, there's no point. Kizaru's just going to kill people. He'd be like, damn, bro, we could have brought this in. We could have arrested them. Nope, he just killed them.
I feel like Kizaru just needs to start murking niggas, alright? Like, Akainu and Kizaru gotta stop. They gotta stop chilling at the Marine base and start just killing niggas, bro. Like, the problem with the Admirals is that they have their strongest person, like leading. Like, that's so fucking stupid, in my opinion. So, like, they're literally just relaxing the whole time while everybody, all the weak admirals are vice admirals are getting the ass whooped.
Nah, but they need the fleet admiral for when really crazy stuff happens. It's like Marine Ford. That's when they have to bring up Sengoku. They're like, damn, shit's serious, though.
But shit's serious. Doflamingo got fucked. The warlords are over. But they need the admirals for, damn, the admirals are fucked now because everybody's getting stronger now.
Yeah, if anything, they need more admirals, bro. I don't think three's enough.
I think vice admirals are actually, like, the equivalent to
a warlord,
warlords in power, like warlord. Mm. You know how warlords could be a Yonko to a buggy, right?
I think
for vice admirals. Mm. We haven't seen a vice admiral really book it out.
No, not really. And I feel like they could probably set that up a little bit with the final fight too. Like
I'm gonna look up vice admirals. I don't know if Sabo fought a vice admiral. If he did, oh yeah, he did. Sabo whooped a vice admiral.
Let's go.
Yeah, it was the nigga with the horns and the eyes. Dots. Yeah, him. Y'all remember?
So my question, I think this is like my last thing that I'm gonna say, for like my closing statement, and it's more of a question. Do y'all think? Because I've been saying this probably for like a while. Do you guys think that we will get Marine 4 Part 2 where it's like Luffy having to save Sabo? And if that's the case, do you think Luffy will actually save him instead of like what happened to Ace?
I don't. Maybe before I kind of did. But then now that like Sabo basically has a cult following, I don't think it'll be easy for the Marines to grab him like that now.
I think it's going to be a situation where like I think Luffy and Vivi are going to meet up again. I think that's gonna happen. And then Vivi's gonna be like, we have to meet up with the revolutionary armies because something's about to go down. And then there's gonna be a situation where like Sabo's fighting like an admiral or something, and then he has to like, Luffy has to step in some way.
Yeah,
that's how I personally feel.
Well, how strong is Sabo in your opinion?
Sabo's pretty strong.
Gotta be Diesel, bro. Because remember, he was up there with just Haki.
Yeah, like, and remember, you gotta remember, as a kid, he was freaking going toe to toe with like vice commanders in the Revolutionary Army. So like,
I think Sabo's stronger than Marco.
Yeah, no, I agree with you.
He might be.
He might be.
Maybe was A stronger than Marco?
I don't know.
I don't think we're able to gauge Ace's
Yeah, because Ace died before the time skip.
Ace got pretty bodied by Blackbeard.
Ace is that you have to dumb down Haki to gauge Ace. You know what I mean? If you don't dumb down Haki, you just think he's just a one trick pony win. He has too many cosigns from too many people just to be some weak one trick pony.
And wasn't he the first commander of the Whitebeard Pirates? Like he has to be strong. He's like there's no doubt that he's strong. It's just again, it's hard to compare because so much stuff happens after the time skip. We learn so much about, you know, the world and like people's powers and stuff.
Yeah, because like looking at it now, I can't see Ace fighting Kaido.
Right.
I can't see Ace even fighting Katakuri. I don't know, man.
Yeah, it's hard to imagine with what we know about Ace.
Yo, not gonna lie, Sabo got the evil side to him, bro.
What do you mean?
Oh shit. Sabo got an evil side to him, bro. Sorry. I was just watching him first of Vice Admiral. This nigga grabbed his face and with the flick, with this evil ass grin, was like, bro, I'm gonna crack your fucking skull, and did it slow.
I'm not surprised, bro.
That's
a lesson, man. Sabo's a street fighter, bro.
Yeah.
He's like also martial arts, like honor shit. He's like, nah, I'm trying to win.
Even though he's not a pirate, like, he might as well, because like, y'all gotta remember the stuff him, Luffy, and Ace were doing as kids. They were not good kids.
Hell no.
Nah, but like, I've never seen Ace evil, bro. Like, every time Ace fight, it's always been out of honor, or just like, Ace already had a Robin Hood vibe when he fought, right? I think Sabo does it, but I've never seen Ace look evil. You
know, and I think that's because we haven't seen enough of Ace, bro. Like, all we've seen about Ace, like, all we know about Ace is that, oh, he met up with Luffy's younger brother, he was nice to his younger brother, and that he was chasing after Blackbeard to avenge a fallen comrade.
Nah, Ace is just I think Ace is, like, just an admirable person, you know what I mean? I feel like Sabo's got to be different from that.
Nah, that's cap. I don't think Ace is a freaking admirable person at all.
You don't think so?
Because before he joined the Whitebeard Pirates, you got to remember he was fucking around with his own crew.
No, but he trusted his crew, though. He fucked with his crew.
Yeah, he trusted his crew, but just because you trust your crew, that doesn't make you a nice person to other people.
I mean, he wasn't, like, an asshole to them. He was, like, caring about that. Like, remember,
no,
like,
I mean, not to his crew. I mean, just, like, to other people. Like, you know, he wasn't just out to sea being nice to everybody. Like, at the end of the day, he's a pirate, you know? They were doing bad things.
Okay, but he had like a Luffy vibe to him. Like, I don't think like you've never seen Luffy.
Even Luffy's not a good person, bro.
Okay, yeah, but I'm saying we've never seen these guys that act evil. Just like idiots. Like they're just idiots that lack respect. I would say that's pirates. All pirates lack respect, right? Yeah. Sabo was just like in this thing. Like you like I'll show you if you scroll to like the very end when Sabo breaks his sword. Sabo just looks at the niggas like. So maybe I feel like that. I feel like that. I might be looking into it a little bit too much, right? But to add that detail, I think Sabo might be a little bit.
Nah, I think you're. I don't think Sabo is like a whole sicko. Like I feel like he's on the same wavelength as like freaking Ace and Luffy.
I think he might be a little. Okay, now go back a little bit. Look at this nigga smile, bro. Yeah, right there. Look. Oh my God, Just Rose was fucking. The pacing just rose to make it. Look at this nigga, bro.
This before you had the fruit, right?
No, it's
no, he had the fruit at this point already.
No, that's not fruit in him.
That's not fruit in him, you're thinking? That's the fruit.
See, so my point is that he can do all that now, but with fire.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Sabo, I think Sabo a threat. I think Sabo a threat, low key.
No.
I don't think the Revolutionary Army is going to be just a good a bunch of good people. I think Sabo might define. I don't know for sure, because remember, I don't think it's a good thing that Sabo's getting his dick sucked around the world. Like.
You think he might become an antagonist and like, oh, I'm the Flame Emperor. No one can.
I think he might be an antagonist for like 3 to 4 chapters. Nothing crazy. You know what I mean? Like a light, like a understanding, like a gray area. You know what I mean? Because
you never know though.
I think the thing about One Piece is that everything is mad gray. Like unlike Naruto and Bleach. Let me take that back. Because they're all gray areas, right? But I think One Piece is just, like, the most gray out of everything. You know what I mean? Like, I just think, like...
I can't see Sabo being a villain.
I can see it. But maybe that's expecting too much.
What would possess him to become a bad guy? Bro? I don't think him getting his dick sucked by a bunch of people is enough for him to be like, oh, yeah, I'm that guy. I can do whatever I want.
I know, but it's like, why?
Because Sabo, the reason I said I can't see it is because Sabo hates, you know, the Celestial Dragons. He hates people that act like that. So why would he become the thing that he hates?
Hey, that'd make a good story plot.
It would, but like, I don't expect something like that.
Isn't he already
like
a Celestial Dragon? Huh? Isn't he already a Celestial Dragon?
I mean, he was.
No, he's from royalty. He's not from a Celestial Dragon. He's from royalty.
I thought he was. Hey.
No, I think no. His family's trying to become it. Remember, like his family tries to act like Celestial Dragons, but he's from royalty.
Yeah. But that's my thing. Like, I don't think Sabo would ever become someone like that. It would depurpose like his whole like character. Bro, literally almost died trying to be a free person, just for him to become that. That's a way too much.
That'd make it like an interesting contrast though to like what happens when you start coming up with power and shit like that, letting it get to you.
Because he got trained in the
by dragon.
Not by dragon, but just with the freaking Revolutionary Army. Like their whole thing is like, you know, we're not dictators. We're not trying to like oppress people.
I feel like Robin would be like, yo. Right. If that happened, because Robin was with the revolution, she is with the Revolutionary Army. They have somebody from the Revolutionary Army with them.
Yeah.
I forgot Robin was part of the Revolutionary Army, bro. Right.
We have to close it up now.
Oh my bad. All right. Well, right. Wano, the whole saga, I'd give it an 8.5 out of 10.
I don't know. I think I don't really have a ranking for Wano, but I can definitely say that I'm very happy to start One Piece, get caught up to where Wano is still happening, and now finally get to see it end like together while being able to be a part of this and like all the other adventures I had like reading this series and shit. Like, it's great, man.
I don't think there's anything like reading One Piece. You know what I mean? Like, there's nothing like reading it. Like, reading it is just great. It's another experience, bro. Yeah, I love it. What's y'all closing thoughts about Wano?
Wano, solid so 6 out of 10 because Zoro didn't open his eye.
Well, I'm personally going to go back to our first reaction because I feel like that was a pretty solid moment. Like, we came in on like one of the hypest chapters of all of One Piece.
We legit did. Okay, every chapter was a banger back. Like, when we came in, like...
Yeah, it was back to back. It was like...
Yeah. Oh, you're not crunk, bro. Like, I don't think we gotta think about it. Bro, it's been 4 months.
Yeah, kind of crazy.
What the fuck? I thought it was like 1 month, bro. It didn't feel like
bro,
months,
that's bro. That's the crazy shit, right?
We've been doing this for a couple months now, kind of wild.
Yeah,
a whole season.
We finished a whole.
Bro, we started
a whole arc in 4 months.
All right. Crazy.
Well,
that's
for the
Usopp saga, so.
Facts, bro. I need to see Usopp shine.
Yo, you're gonna need Kyle to be. Remember what Kyle said about Usopp, bro. What's so important about Usopp, bro?
We
need
this is it. This is when Usopp becomes important.
Bro, listen, we can't have Kyle have 2 W's because he already got 1 W with the Marines being.
Nah, he was spitting, bro. The Marines are actually trash.
No,
right now.
Bro. I think it was Green Bull. Green Bull fucked up.
It's not just Green Bull, bro. The Marines have been taking L's for quite some time, in my opinion.
I mean, they've always been posers. But
I'm just saying, ever since Marineford, that's just my opinion. I think they've been thinking else.
Yeah, I feel that. But it's like shit. We don't know. I think to show the Marines power, they gotta like capture Bo or something. You know what I'm saying? Or like they like the Marines like it. Bro, it's just like Eddie's Lobby. Because, like, you're like, after Eddie's Lobby, you think the Marines are nothing. Or not, like, let me say nothing.
I don't know.
Okay, let me not say nothing, but it's like, you think, like, or Alabasta or something. Like, you think the Marines are not that crazy, right? Like,
we didn't
you, like,
even see any legit Marines in Alabasta.
Oh, yeah, that's true. We saw Smoker, but Smoker was just like, damn, this shit sucks. But, no, legit. So, I think what Oda's going to have to do, he has to establish the Marines as a power now because they cannot be the evil. They cannot be the antagonists of the Straw Hats if they're going to be weak like this. So they need to take out, and everybody's predicting it's going to be Boa. And it might be Boa. I'm not denying that, but we'll see.
Next chapter, I'm trying to see Cobra Dusty. That's what I want. I'm trying to see him on the floor. BB's like, that.
I don't think there's gonna be any breaks.
I don't. Yeah, it didn't say there's a break here.
So. Yeah, no breaks. No breaks.
We just going, bro. We out here.
All right, Matt. Sayonara, brethren. Wano, pretty cool.
Matt about to sleep.
Thank you guys for coming along with the ride. Leave a like, subscribe. Do you guys think the Marines are Mickey Mouse? Tell us in the comments. And shout out to Kyle.
Oh god, shout out to Kyle. Also, shout out to Kyle, y'all. We hit 50 subs, bro. We're halfway to 100.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Kind of crazy.
50 sub special.
We're gonna get Roger Base. Oh, one of these manga reactions one day, bro. Probably never, but one day, bro. You,
Roger Base at no. Pace of Pete at 100 subs. Roger Base at 1K.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, yo, I will. Listen, Peso Pete follows me at 100 subs. I will DM Peso Pete to ask him to join us.
Peso Pete better be
able to get a 30-second Peso Pete
interview. At 100 subs, we're going to commission Peso Pete for an
interview. I will.
Okay. All right.
But yeah, that's
goodbye.
The show.
Goodbye.
Peace out.